That's some shenanigans, man. Like, come on. That was such a good run. Two extra jumps in brutality. Oh my. So you know what? I like this a great deal. What was the killing deck one? Shots leave a trail of frames. I don't really care. Like, how are you gonna run up to me and hit me exactly when I'm coming down off of the damn shockwave? That's garbage. Okay. All right. Gotta have a short memory. Bad game. This game is so bad. I don't know why y'all play it. Why did y'all want me to play this game, chat? This game sucks. You don't? Oh, well, that's fair. All right. What would you rather? What would you rather have on stream here? I streamed Noita the other day. How do you feel about some Noita? Because that game is like, I don't want to say I'm addicted, because I don't think I'm quite there yet. But like, it's not far off. That thing is so much fun. Even though it is like sitting through a university lecture. Also, I've disrespected Lightspeed, I think, a little too much. This thing is fun. No. Feel that Noita has been in my library since you bought it, and after buying it, it was present in your library. Truer words have never been spoken. So is that one then that you haven't tried or are not a huge fan of? Because we had Beard Ashmore over in the chat the other day, and he was saying he was not a fan of it either, which I was, you know, which is fine. Everyone's entitled to their opinion. But yeah, I just love that game, man. Hollow Knight, ooh. I do still need to play Hollow Knight, actually. That's a great idea. That's actually a really great idea. I would love to do that. No. We got food. More, I don't want to suddenly lose 300 hours of your life. Yeah, I think that's the exact kind of game that will do that. Because, like, there's so much depth. Like, holy cow. I'm still just shocked at how much there is in that game. And I've barely scratched the surface. I haven't even, like, I think I've gotten to, I don't know, out of the early game, quote unquote, maybe literally once. And yeah, I'm no good. Rather you see you play Jupiter Hell after you first answer the question, what is Jupiter Hell? You know what? Just to see if there was a Humble Bundle or something and that is actually a game that exists. Let's go H-I-J. The only J's I have are Jotun, Valhalla Edition, and Just Cause 2 multiplayer dedicated server. So yeah, what is Jupiter Hell? That is not one that I'm familiar with, if it's even a real thing, which I'm about 50-50 on right now. A modern, traditional roguelike. Okay. I can get down with that. What makes it traditional if it is modern? Oh, dear. Y'all aren't beasts? That's okay. No beasts required. Turn-based, tile-based, procedural generated, and permadeath. Those are things that I'm a big fan of. Turn-based and tile-based. So, okay. This is going to show my ignorance on full display. Wasn't Rogue, or like one of the very first Rogues, or Roguelikes, Roguelites, text-based? I feel like I remember reading something about History of Roguelikes where there was one that was like very big early on that was like text-based. We could totally do Brutality freaking baseball bat. Oh my god. Hang on, what else do we have? Okay. Many roguelikes in Rogue have ASCII interfaces. Okay. They're still turn-based, tile-based games. Very interesting. Okay. I like that. And it's got the modern aspect, so it's like it's fleshed out and polished and with today's, like, you know, standards of game and whatnot. Jupiter Hell. You know what? Ooh, the Steam Spring sale is on right now, by the way. Jupiter Hell. It is not on sale. No, it is. 60% off. Jupiter Hell. Looks really interesting. It looks like, I mean, just from screenshots, kind of like a XCOM Hotline Miami, almost. But like you say, turn-based. Huh. Looks interesting. I'll definitely give it a look. Burning oil. I mean, come on. How could we not? All right. So if we're going to do a brutality-based baseball bat, we could sewers. The dev originally made a game called Doom RL and got a cease and desist, so they made Jupiter Hell instead. It's turn-based Doom. Huh. That's really interesting. I haven't actually played Doom. I think I have the new one from a Humble Bundle or something. And maybe I like started it up and literally did like the first mission or something, but you could manip the scroll. Let's not rock the boat. But I love watching, watching Doom speedruns. Like, that shit is so cool. And we absolutely have to do, I mean, Porcupac could be something. Maybe later. Combo first? Melee first? Because on melee first, we'll be able to breach them a lot better. If we get a couple big stacks of slow, then they start freezing and then we stun them out. I think we go melee then combo. And this is gonna be a bank too. You know what? We'll just pretend we didn't see that one. If you ever want to play traditional roguelikes, also known as actual roguelikes, there's tons of free games. Really? I don't know that, so by that definition, I don't know that I have ever played a traditional actual roguelike. I'm trying to think of, because like the ones that I would have spent the most time in are like Binding of Isaac, Dead Cells, more roguelites, I guess. Although I'm hardly a stickler for the terminology in situations like that. Almost definitely I haven't. Okay. There was one what about something like Loop Hero? Because that's kind of it's not really turn-based, but it is kind of tile-based. If you're familiar with that one. No? Okay. That's fine. I'm just trying to like grasp at anything that I might have, that might potentially have been. Crown Trick is close, still not quite there. I don't think I've done that one either. I think I would like to, you know, as much as I like the roguelite genre, It would be interesting to see, you know, more, and something that's more akin to the actual source, you know? I'd be down. And Jupiter Hell, I mean, it looks good. Like, I'm just gonna be real. From the, you know, 5 screenshots that I scrolled through just now, it looks like a fun time. The only problem with, like, oh my god, you didn't explode yet. The only problem I have with turn-based games like that is generally that they just take way too much of my time. Because I overanalyze and strategize every single thing and every little thing. And not even, like, as a roguelike, but I play Tactics Ogre quite a bit. Tactics Ogre Reborn is like a... That's an extra jump, we'll keep that around. Is one that came out. It's like a remaster of a remaster or something. But that one is like... I mean, hundreds of hours just going through the standard base game missions. And it's like... It's fun. But I have to, like, not... I have to pull myself away. Or else let AI take over, you know, half of my team, because otherwise I will sit there and scrutinize and optimize every single thing, you know what I mean? It can get to be a little bit much on turn-based games in such a way, but who made the first roguelike? I'm gonna pull out the history books. I don't know. Who made Rogue? Wasn't Rogue was from like the 80s or something, right? Like, it was very old. I bet you there's a Wikipedia article on the whole history of roguelikes. That would be fun to look up. I think there's a... No. If you're interested in a modern graphical take, Jupiter Hell and Cogmind, probably best entry points, but if you don't mind the graphics, Infra Arcana, Brogue, and Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup. Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup also has the best name of any of them, and that's incredible. They're amazing and all free. Ooh, very nice. That sounds like a lot of fun. I'm going to have to, you know what? Let me take a screenshot of that real quick so that I don't... Because I'm very bad... about, all right, got the screenshot, about taking recommendations from chat when I don't make notes of them, because then I forget, and sometimes I catch them on the VODs when I'm editing them for YouTube, but that's inconsistent at best. So yeah, that's why I need to take notes when we're doing German lessons or whatever as well, to make sure that I don't forget Geborgenheit and Unterschlich, I think was the... I don't know, I have a note, so... But yeah, I'm not usually a stickler for graphics as much. For example, I actually went back and played... I played Oblivion after having completed Skyrim and loved every second of it. Oh my goodness, that was a panic parry. So I'm not... graphics are not usually what does it for me. What does it for me is usually when, like, when the controls are not as tight, you know? Like, some older platformers or games, like the original Mega Man, for example, I think. Maybe it's just because I'm not used to them or haven't spent a lot of time with them historically, but they feel not very good by modern standards. Perhaps, to me, you know, having played them only a handful of times, but, yeah, that's what I'm more of a stickler on when it comes to, like, minimalist or older games, is if the controls are, like, weird, or Contra. I got a Super Nintendo Classic thing, the little mini Super Nintendo that's basically just a legal emulator, and I tried to play through Contra. And that is just fucking impossible. Like, it is not possible to beat that game if you're only a modern gamer. It's so hard. And the controls are, like, Yeah, they just don't feel great. Jupiter Hell, one of the main goals was to make it controller friendly. Hey, I'd love to see that. A lot of originals require the entire keyboard. Very interesting. Huh. I do prefer playing on a controller whenever possible. But there are even some, I mean, this is just better. There are some, even like relatively modern roguelites that really just don't translate very well to a controller, I think. I think one of the main examples of that in my mind has been Dungreed, if y'all are familiar with that one. It just doesn't feel like it's, at least the like initial developer suggested key bindings don't feel intuitive all that much compared to others. Still a fun game, but it's one that I have to break out the keyboard and mouse for, which means that I don't, killstreak. I actually don't play it as much as I want to, because I don't like playing keyboard and mouse on games like this when I don't have to. Hang on. This is a little spicy. I did not ask for extra hot. I'm a wuss. I go about as hot as Crystal Sauce, if y'all are familiar with the Crystal's Louisiana hot sauce. It's just a nice cayenne pepper sauce. So good. That's the kind my daddy would always eat on everything. And it's really good. Great on eggs, you know? Where are we even going? What are we talking about? I don't even know, man. Most NES era retro games are tackleable, but they definitely require a different mindset. Yeah. I'm not even sure what these acronyms are. I'm trying to, Ghouls and Goblins, was that one? Or Ghosts and Ghouls, one of those? I know that one is like super, super hard. I don't know that I know what NGs and CVs is, off the top of my head anyways. Oh, Castlevania's and Ninja Gaidens. True. Yeah. Actually, I think there is a Ninja Gaiden on the little Nintendo thing that I have as well. Maybe. I feel like I've tried a Ninja Gaiden. But no, because that's a Super Nintendo. Unless there's one that came out for Super Nintendo. I don't know. I'm very much new blood when it comes to gaming. We weren't actually allowed to have game consoles when I was growing up, which is interesting. Save states, of course, are on the ban list. Naturally, like why? Those would be too far too easy, far too accessible. Like I figured that just went without saying, you know. I mean, if we're not even going to be using Armadillo Pack or, you know, going for a run where you can actually buy a health potion if needed, why would, who would ever think that save states would be allowable? That's laughable. Psh, save states. Not for this guy. Not for the god gamers among us. Also never played Among Us, which that one I don't have any qualms about. It's just not for me, you know. I understand it had its moment. Might even still be having its moment, honestly. I'm out of the loop on that one, but yeah. Not what I'm interested in. My brother's tried to get me to play it a couple times. Oh my god, get off the ladder. Crazy that you would even think that aloud. I wouldn't think that aloud. It literally would not have crossed my mind to ever have a discussion on save states at all. I until it was brought up, it did not enter my mind palace. Hang on. We want to not be super duper spicy here. Because like I said, I'm a wimp. I am growing cayenne peppers though. I'm so excited. I'm going to try and make my own hot sauce. Assuming I can get the peppers to actually work. I'm not good with peppers. I think the first batch that I've started as seedlings are going to die. If they haven't already died. Yeah, sure. Interestingly enough, the new Ghosts and Goblins Resurrection is way harder than the NES game ever was. Really? That is actually very interesting. What makes it so much more difficult? Because I assume they've got, like... Let's just get out of here. I don't want to go back and waste time to sell one amulet. Let's go to prison. Yes. Yeah. I assume they've, like, the graphics, the controls and everything are, like, tighter and more modernized and stuff, which I think was a big issue with the original Ghouls and Ghosts and Goblins. And, like, there was... I think I remember there being some, like, bullshit RNG stuff that would come and get you. I watched Ryukar do a playthrough of it. He might have done a full playthrough... He might not have, I don't remember. It's been a while, but it just, yeah, it doesn't look like something I would ever complete. I might like take a swing at it and get very frustrated, and I might actually rage quit. Like, games like that might actually make me rage quit. You know, it doesn't happen often, but it certainly can happen. Okay. I think we do. Knife dance has been good, but now we focus. Come on. Oh my, really? What is this? I'm doing it again. I'm doing the thing where I almost got stuck on the ladder or the wall. Come on. Okay. All right. This sucks, man. No! Ho ho! I was for surely dead. My god. Who? Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Oh my god. Thank goodness. Jesus Christ. I am so incredibly clenched. Y'all have no idea. Like, I saw the entire run flash before my eyes. Bro, this... I'm just gonna say, this here brutality... baseball bat is doing work. Haters be damned. And there's... You know what? Now we have an answer for when Beard comes back and says, oh, well, you have to take half of your stuff off color when doing Brutality Bat. Just take the melee mutation because it slows him down, and then bada bing, bada boom, you're made into shade. You don't get to elitize. That's it. You don't even need to take anything off color. All you got to do is just set up the right mutation. No! Damn it. Come on. No! Everything is getting me! Good! No. No. This is... death. Stupid, horrible, horrible death. That was not the skill that I wanted to use. I need to take a breather after that one. Holy hell! Are they dead? You're not dead. I actually think that's kind of everyone though. Holy cow, you know what? Might as well. Arm blaze is so damn high. I don't know how we got out of that one just being real. And melee mutation being able to slow down them birds feels mighty fine. Because you don't stun them anyways, but you don't usually have a way to make them slow down and whatnot. I've been doing a big brain strat recently where you let one guy go elite and then kill them for more malaise reduction. Is that... So, I think I've seen that in some... Maybe Psyche, maybe it's V.me. I've seen that they try and do that in maybe their old videos, but I think it's been a little inconsistent on whether or not it actually does reduce the malaise if they're not, like, natural elites. But does that actually work? I haven't paid enough attention on my own games to be able to say. But that's actually, I mean, that's not even big brain. That's just good tech. Cause shoot, if that's the case, like, this damn malaise is getting way too high. It has been working, dude. Hell yes. That might be the... Oh, the shield. That might be the way. Please. I swear to God. While the Inquisitor frickin' snipes me, and while my guitar gently weeps. Just let me take a swing at your noggin. God. Oh no, there's another. Okay. Now we can actually fight. Hang on. We can do this. Because you're gonna burn the damn water? You're the elite one. No. There's another elite! Why? Hang on. No, some of y'all just have to die, is the thing. There's one. Nope. This is fine. I will run around, do a little dipsy doodle. I do not care. Oh my god. I'm gonna heal. Holy shit, man. I can't believe I'm alive. How the hell am I alive? You know what? I was just trying the big brain strat. Pro tip, don't do it in the corrupted prison with toxic miasmas, but otherwise, I think you might be onto something. Dude, are you joking? Yeah. Let's keep the flammable oil. Where are we doing? Sewers or ramparts? We could even actually just go ramparts. We could do ramparts, food shop, come back to conjunct for the scroll fragments. Let's try it. We're learning new things, we're experimenting a little bit, and holy cow, I feel like I'm playing well. I don't feel like that often, but my god. Whew. What's this one at? 10 elite enemies. What else makes sense? Do we have any... No, like, bleed or anything. What about Heart of Ice? I passed it, didn't I? Oh, it's this one. Slowed, stunned, frozen, or rooted enemy at close range reduces skill cooldowns. There could be something here. Everything's going to be slowed from melee mutation, and they're going to be comboed, and then we're going to Heart of Ice, and then we're going to get our cooldowns, and then we're going to root them with the Wolf Trap, and then we're going to go to Iowa, then we're going to go to Delaware, then we're going to go to the White House, and... Ah. You're witnessing a man lose his mind in real time. I think there's something to it. Oh my goodness. All right. Let's see what we got. Brutality baseball bat. Card of Ice is great with grenades. Ooh. Interesting. Yeah, because they're... That would be good. We could make grenades work. Okay, but see, now we're feeding into Beard Ashmore's theory that we have to take everything off color in order to make a brutality baseball bat work. But like, how do we not? 18 seconds and we'll be able to just nuke that down. I think let's just in for a penny, in for a pound, right? That's so funny. Oh man, that's actually perfect. Finally, someone figured out how to make baseball that good. Yeah, right? It's crazy that it took this long. You'd think they'd balance it correctly, right? Oh, you douchebag. Also, I would love to get a better than level 4 baseball bat, though. Like, that would just make my heart sing. Like a wild thing. You can't roll through that one. You can't. I know you can't. I don't know why I tried. This is why we go to the food shops. Because I'm bad at this game. Two cell door? I know it's two cell door in the graveyard. Yeah, and we're getting some not great cooldown reduction because it is off color, but it's not nothing. It is the food shop. Hell yes. Do we have enough for another one too? Mein Gott. Fucking love to pop out German whenever I can. Okay. Maybe then the real play. That was a bad parry. Oh, ha, ha, ha. The real play is just going completely red-green instead of spreading out your health between green and purple. Maybe you just focus green to get the Heart of Ice and other survival mutations pumped up. Finally got true ending last week. That run was hard carried by a plus 75% to rooted baseball bat, so I'm not counting it. Dude, no. That's wrong. Count that shit, because, like, why would you not? As long as, like, I wouldn't personally count an aspect run, because that's so transformative as to make the run a little just different, different category, I would say. But if you just got, like, if you just got a killer combo, dude, celebrate that shit. Hell, I would. Totally negatory. I don't know, man. Yeah. Totally negatory? Like, there's nothing to it at all? I mean, you end up with... I'm assuming we're talking about the scroll. Did I leave anything? No. That's some big brain scroll action right there. Going two color, there's nothing to it other than making the game harder. Okay. But what if? Like, because I know you're gonna nerf yourself out of some health, right? But then if you're getting if you're pumping up like I don't know, something in, probably not Heart of Ice. Yeah, there's, you're probably right. Now that I think about the actual benefit that you'd be getting versus the cost that it would take, that does actually make a lot of sense. Probably not worth it. Back when two stat legendaries was a thing, but that's not a thing anymore. I do remember reading about that, or seeing, I think, some old videos about how legendaries used to scale off your top two stats instead of just being, like, colorless. It was very interesting. I'm kind of glad I didn't play for that, because going from that to where we're at now is, like, it would be a major, major shift. I'm glad I only have to worry about dealing with the one system. Dude. Whoops. Hang on. We can do this. It's utterly broken? Wow. I mean, so the scaling was still the same? Like, you would get... Wait, because instead of it would be... just off of your highest, it would be off your highest two, then. So they had just incredible, like, they would be scaling so much more. I didn't even, the highest two added. That didn't, for some reason I was thinking that it was such that they would have, like, different scaling, so there wouldn't, it wouldn't just be in, like, 45, as if you had 45 scrolls in that stat at the end game or something. It would just be, like, something different entirely. But now that doesn't make sense. hang on. Legendaries have had a lot of iterations, as has Malaise. Which, again, I'm really glad that I didn't have to deal with anything but the current iteration, because I like the current iteration. I think it works very well. I would not have done very well in a instant death, or a whatever it sets you to, 10% health something. I would not have done well with that at all. That one was two tactics, I'm pretty sure. I barely do well with the current iteration, so, you know, it's okay. This one's fun though. Oh, get rooted. No. Get rooted and booted. And scooty dooted. Who are you hitting, my guy? Ain't nobody there for you to hit. Do we have biters? Oh, we do have biters. Never mind. There's someone there for you to hit. Oy, whatever. Alright, so there's Concierge. I could go Conjunct. I think I want to go Conjunct. We've got enough immobilization that I think she wouldn't be the worst. Very nice. Okay. I think a common theme for the, some of those days when I am just like, I can't get out of the first, I can't see a boss, right? When I play that badly, is not hitting my parries effectively, or else generally trying to go shieldless. I did see, actually, there's a scroll. And then you have days like today where I'm actually hitting quite a few parries. Some that I think have literally saved the entire run. And this is not typical. Okay. There are enough dudes. Holy. Let's get stuns off our damn parries. Oh man, alright. Super mega intense focus. on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Two more, two more, two more, two more. Okay. All right. That was easy. That one was actually easy. Damn. Freaking curse chest on the ramparts. Are you kidding me? So that's going to help make up for the fact that ramparts is objectively worse than the toxic sewers, ancient sewers. So that feels mighty nice. Yeah. Is there anything else? There's another fragment we missed. Nothing. Okay, so we're going to be at 15 for the boss. It's not the worst. Ooh, baby. Does this one have? No. Thought it might have had root. Because that would be... that would be insane. Also, we just need a damn better bat. Like, that would just make my entire life at this point. That's okay. Oh man, imagine we get some fatty stuns on conjunct with the parry. Poor girl won't know what hit her. Okay. That should be the floor. I think we checked the shop, right? Did we roll it down? Double check real quick. Oh, and it was weapons too. Conjunct is a beast for crowbar. It would do more damage on conjunct specifically. It is 8 grand though. And we're gonna need to buy another health flask, so we'd be real low for another crowbar run. I mean, that one was... I really like the crowbar, but not when we're trying to do brutality bats. I think we need to save our money, and this should... I mean, there's no way this is still good enough to do this, right? We're gonna see. Conjunct shouldn't be too hard. We can do conjunct. It might take a little while. 126 kill streak. I actually didn't even notice. My goodness. A legendary on the frantic sword. Now we could talk. But not just a... not a regular run of the mill when we're not even running anything to enable it. I don't know, what would enable a frantic sword other than just, like, taking damage? And not even, like, in a vengeance way. But yeah, if we get the chance to do another crowbar run tonight, I would absolutely do that. Alright, yes, come down here. You didn't root? I thought you could root. I thought I've seen conjunct root before. Thank goodness for the slow. I was not getting out of that the right way. Hell yeah. All right. Let's get some wolf traps. Nice. Let's get some more wolf traps. Ah! Get destroyed, you freaking idiots. Oh! Oh, you're rooted as hell! Oh my god! Oh, that's incredible. I love that so much. No! Oh, damn it! My roll timer was not all the way down. I thought the cooldown was okay. Now I'm just being bad. Barricade. could be, yeah. Because then you'd have, I mean, you'd have to build up a lot of the temporary health and having... The barricade health doesn't go away while you still have barricade, right? That's, I'm not thinking of the legendary that, like, makes the health never go away. I'm thinking of the legendary, like, ice armor. Oh, you asshole. I shouldn't be right there. Okay, come on. Just, like... All right. We lost the plot a little bit at the end, but that's okay. Playing on 1.8 would enable it, because Frantic was once S tier. Really? What was changed? Was it just the stats were much better? Or did it have a different effect? Because I don't... took less damage than you usually do, and you're underleveled. Really? Huh. Thank you, Newtons. I needed that. Sometimes I am my own worst critic. Everyone is their own worst critic. I feel like me especially so sometimes, but yeah. You are right, we're only at 16, and this is a brutality build that I'm not used to fighting conjunct with, so thank you, my friend. I needed that. You can easily sit at 50% malaise on 1.8, and that creeps the crit condition. Oh, interesting. So what is the... In 1.8, what is the crit... Or the, is the malaise every time you get hit, it gives you a stack of malaise? Is that the one? Or is... That's before it was timer-based, right? Every time you get hit. Okay, so you get hit, like, 5 times, and then you're just, like, chilling, doing incredible damage. And 10% health at 10 ways. Gotcha. Okay. Dang, that is really interesting. Huh. So, you know, very high risk, high reward, to be sure. But that's, yeah, certainly not untenable. That is a one hell of a... Welcome to the damn... Welcome to the jungle there. Okay. Oh my goodness, where did you even come from? Also, we desperately need a good weapon shop. I want to keep running the bat, but I can't be running a level 4 bat. Hang on. Oh my god, really? Get spiked, you... You're not allowed to get spiked? Douchebag. No. Just keep swinging. Just keep swinging. Just keep swinging, swinging, swinging. What do we do? We swing. And apparently we can't hit rats anymore. That's okay. That's why we go to the food shops, man. 35% though. Don't... Why would there even be an option to go on spikes at that point? So that dude can get spiked, but not the other dude that I actually wanted to be spiked? No. You know, I was just thinking, man, maybe 35% is a little too low to be running around without using another health pot. 13 definitely is. You know what? I actually think that's okay. 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 Dang, and we passed the bank as well, didn't we? Because it was an early one. Fucking rats! Just out of reach of my bat. We're okay. Nope. You will be frozen. You will be stunned. Dude. That dude wasn't going anywhere. Holy. I can swing all day. Me, when I'm 65, move to a retirement community and start to realize what the locals there actually do all day. Anyways, we're gonna move past that one. All right, what do we got? Dude, even a baseball bat? Oh. Just imagine the damage we could be doing. Cricket sounds, yeah. Better crickets than like tomatoes being thrown or like, "Burr, you suck." I would take crickets over that. Hey, is this thing on? So what's the deal with airline food? Etc., etc. See, I can rebound from that easy. Maybe not easy. It's gonna be a psychological scar that will haunt me to the end of my days, but you know, we'll be okay. All right, so we need to do this intelligently, which means we do this. Okay, not everything got hit by my grenade, but that's okay. Extra jump, just in case we'll hold on to it. Holy cow. I actually observed the environment before down smashing there. Are y'all so proud of me? I'm kind of proud of me. I'm not gonna lie. That's not something I would normally do. I feel good. I feel good on this one. All right, food shop, here we go. Give me that young flask. We might come back for the rest as well. There's the shores already. My goodness. Okay. Gonna give us some health. We're not gonna build up too much in green. Oh, shoot. Man, this sucks. This sucks a great deal. Come on, cannibal. Okay. This no longer sucks a great deal. That actually went kinda well. Man. Am I good at this game again? Can I actually be good at this game? Oh, I hate being not good at this game. Hang on. I don't like what you've got going on. Also, you know what? I would rather pick up these scrolls and such and find the curse. That's what matters. Curse is the biggest thing. And if there's dudes, there's no dudes. Celador doesn't give dudes. I should know. I should have known skills. It's kind of a bummer. I shouldn't have picked brutality. Man, okay, so immediately for all of my bragging on myself, I am making some pretty hefty misplays. Because we're not running brutality skills at the moment. Legendary something or other. You're an elite. You are dead. An extra jump. We'll get rid of this one. Save the other. Better. Very good. It's a cocoon! Okay, but like, we could reroll the 100% damage taken. Because even when the cocoon doesn't, even when it doesn't get the parry, it still does a little whoosh and stuns things out. There could be something there. I don't think there is, but there could be. Hmm. Did they change the cocoon's legendary? I don't know. I'm not sure. Oh, this is just cavern. What, did it not used to be freezes the enemies with a parry? That's the only one I've... I don't ever see, think I've seen it as anything else. Oh! Okay, this will be the curse then. Yes. Plenty of dudes. Okay. Alright. Are these easy dudes? These are not dudes at all. No. I like where our skills are at. Whew. Time to get nervous again. Seismic strike. Okay. That's what they want to do. You know what? There's something to be said about seismic strike in the backpack getting armadillo, porcupack, and then rolling through, getting roots on things, smacking them with a baseball bat. There's something there. I cannot make it work, but someone could, I think. It just would not be me. Probably. Okay, y'all are just rats, hang on. Oh, baby. I'm not gonna get fooled by fucking falling down on a on an Inquisitor's shot. Not in this lifetime. Rats behind me, though. Still fair game. Whew, okay. Thought it was if you miss the parry, it will reduce cooldown based on how many you hit previously. Oh, interesting. You know, actually, that sounds so familiar. Maybe that's something that has gotten changed in the beta branch that I'm not running right now. I could totally see that being a thing. Because I do remember seeing like a legendary guide slash tier list slash thing. I think it was V.me. And I want to say he had something like that in there. Bro. These sticks are killing me. Alright, this is not good. Oh, the legendary tier list, and that was it from V.me? Well, then, you know what? He knows better than I would, that's for sure. Oh my god, now I'm stuck between spikes in a hard place. Hang on. This is fine. We're just going back to the food shop. We're gonna pick up a little chicken dinner, a poultry dinner. No problem. We're good. Okay, cavern. Should sell the cocoon. I'm not gonna take it. But there is something. This isn't even the thing there was something there for, but there's something there. Freezes enemies, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. So depending on when V.me's tier list came out, it could either be the way it used to be or a how it is going to be upcoming. That is really funky, though. Those were skills, right? Yeah. We've been there, we've been there, we've been here. We've been everywhere. Let's get out of here. Okay, so now, in the cavern, we are going to get a better baseball bat. It must happen if we're gonna have any chance. Do we want to? I mean, it's really not worth re-rolling any of this stuff. Our gear is so low leveled. We're at 21 scrolls? I'm actually in hell. That is nothing. I'm still running the starter bat. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We desperately need something better. Oh. But that's the power of the brutality bat. You do not get frozen from your backside. Hang on. We can do this. No, get slowed. God. Okay. I don't know that dude's patterns all that well. I tried to double jump and then that's... I apparently don't get my jumps back in time. So that's cool. This is going to be a very tricky floor. Okay. At least until we get to a shop. And God almighty, give me a fucking anything. Because if it's not going to be... If they're not going to give me a bat... Yo, Steph! What's going on? Thank you so much for the raid. What is up? You are just in time to witness a man lose his mind. How is your stream, my friend? Because we are in a pickle. Oh, Steph, you were here actually for the other day for the discussion on the brutality baseball bat. Well, well, well. If it isn't a little brutality baseball bat. And we're making it work, by God. It's very dangerous. And it's still the level 4 from the first area, but it's actually like there's something to it. Obviously with the off-color things that are necessary, but fun runs. One win and two stupid deaths. Well, you got me so far. Actually, you know what? We're at two stupid deaths now. Y'all didn't tell me that my death counter was wrong. I think we're at two stupid deaths, and we're angling to try and get a... Hopefully to be able to get a good one out of this. That's awesome, dude. I'm happy to hear that. What was, you didn't even see the counter? That's also fair. That's also fair. What kind of stupid deaths are we talking about? Because I had, check a clip that Lemon made. Dude, hell yeah. Nothing wrong with that. I saw that Lemon posted a meme the other day on the subreddit. It was a lot of fun. Something about the Chinese community of Dead Cells versus the Europe and American communities of Dead Cells, and how, like, in America we can't fight a boss for more than 2 seconds without being in severe trouble, which is honestly true. Bro, I'm in hell. Holy shit. I shouldn't have done any of that. Nope. Oh, that was the wrong button to parry. You're actually gonna fuck me up here, aren't you? Okay. All right. Damn it. Don't want to have to use a health flask. It's all falling apart. Okay, but like... I need a shop. More than anything. I need a freaking shop. And then I will come back and I will kill all these people. I promise. Yeah, I need to stop trying to kill things. It's just, it had been working, you know? For a while. But now it's... We're definitely running up against it. We just do not have the deeps. All right, shop. I shouldn't have picked brutality, but I'm just a little upset, honestly. Okay. We're gonna go sneaky sneaky mode again. I say again, like we tried that at all. We have not tried that yet. I'm not gonna not kill everything. But I am gonna not kill many things. If you ever find a legendary ice shards or a phaser, go with Wish and make the one you didn't find. Okay. What do they do? I'm not sure I know them. You can't even be rooted. An assault shield and legendary assault shield. Send me a whisper or a DM. I think the links are off by default on here. But yeah, I'll check it out. Send it to me. We're running into big problems for obvious reasons. Thank you. Okay, yeah, I'll check that out in a little bit. So here's the thing, though. Spin to win is really interesting. Double ice shards and double phaser? Oh, so you just get them both? Or you get them with their non-legendary counterparts as well? That's so funny. That sounds really cool. Alright, hang on. Honestly? Not even trying to mess with that dude right now. Are you gonna teleport up here though? No. Scroll fragment. You don't get frozen. I don't remember that. I think there's a shop down this way, and I definitely don't want to fuck with this dude, but we can kill him. Okay. No, shop. Okay. We can do this. Don't forget, this game is easy. At its core, this is an easy game. All you have to do is not take damage and die. There's really nothing more to it. Oh, you didn't get... Okay. We're good. That certainly helps. Come up here. Actually having some stats helps out a great deal. That helps out a great deal, oh my god. No, I couldn't roll in time. Where is a shop? No. One of y'all just elitified? It was your ass. It actually let me drop down. I'm stunned. Hang on. We can do this. We can totally do this. We just gotta not panic. That's the thing, is panic is good when it works, but it oftentimes doesn't. And if we don't have to panic, why panic? I honestly thought they were gonna die sooner than that. Okay, douchebag. I'm gonna be real with you. I don't know how much longer I can keep this going. No! Okay. Freaking based little trap thingies. I don't know, man. Just a wafer thin shop would go so hard. Alright, scroll fragment. I mean, look. The trap slingshots, the whatever they, I don't even know. What are the, like, little gaslight son bitches? Do that. Now, we do this and we get you, okay. 100% intended trap kill. See, you get it. Skills. So they give us two skills shops. I am dying here. Like, unironically, I will die here. This is will be where I die. I buried the fucking thing. I can't believe it. You can't believe it, because I certainly can't believe it. Hold on. This is awful. Wrong mindset. Dude. God, are you fucking kidding me? You're actually goddamn joking. What the hell is this run? Y'all see that? Do y'all see this shit? This little sumbitch right here? Mimic is the cherry on top, and we have a curse chest. We're dead. Like, actually dead on this floor. Although the damage is, oh my god, night and freaking day. Please just do your thing. We can actually one-shot those dudes in a thing. This bat is incredible. This bat is... Why did it wait until now? Yeah, no, that is a damn good bat. All right, fuck it. Let's do it. We're so dead. There's no way. A 14 bat is divine. Absolutely gorgeous. All right, and if we're not missing like scrolls or stars or anything down below, I'm not going to fuck with it. So let's... Two more scrolls. Let's do it and see what we can do. There's a dude up here. You gotta reforge that for more against rooted and stunned. Yeah, I sure do. I also need to find a way to not take damage against the next boss and the next biome and then the next boss after that. And then we'll definitely be set. Shit, I forgot I was cursed for a second. Can I be real with you? I was just like running around and like doing willy-nilly with mimbly-bimbly. Whatever, I actually forgot that I was under a curse. Oh my god. That's not gonna do it. That will. Shit. Alright. We can get that one later. Yeah, we've still only got a pretty bad amulet. Man. Just absolute hilarious timing on when this shit decides to show up. But like, honestly, can we pat ourselves on the back just a little bit for making it this far with a level 4 bat. Yo, Goosey, what's going on? How are ya? Good to see ya. You are just in time to witness a loss. And I am saying this as kind of a sandbag to maybe make it so that it doesn't actually come true. No backpats. Well, okay, fine. Like to see you get here with a level 4 baseball bat. Oh wait, you don't play fun things, so that's cool. Sorry for the backsitting, but consider Tainted Flask. No, that is good, because I actually was not going to consider Tainted Flask, so that is really... That will be very good on if we can get past the giant. Or the scarecrow. I don't like this against the scarecrow, but I don't like this against the giant either. Lost again against the collector. No, man. That blows. I've been there a lot. Like a lot. Especially recently. And not even just on the collector, but on the, like, paths leading up to. That's been a hoot and a half. Or the biomes leading up to. That is just such a bummer. I would never be able to live down using the bat. They would crucify me. Who's they? I don't know that they exist, my friend. Like, what are these amulets, man? At least we made it up to 28. Oh, Lemon Shock and Lydia. Okay. That is a valid bay. That is a valid day. Withdrawn. Finish this run. I mean, I'm gonna try. I don't have high hopes. I think, honestly, I'd rather just leave the floor at this point. Wait, there was one elite. Right? Like, up here? Let's kill this one elite. One more elite to check for a better amulet. Very true. Thank you for saving me from myself. I was about to forget. Lissai. Okay. That's cool. See, if we were doing a survival bat, this would have been a completely different story. Please go upwards and over. All right. Let's just go to the giant. Let's get out of here. Oh, it just breaks my heart. I think the food item already dropped on this floor too. Lemon and Shock, I understand, but doesn't Lydia complain about every item that is embarrassingly OP? I mean, that just sounds like Makiri over here. Also, Vord, what's going on, dude? It's been a minute. How you doing? You're about to witness the end of this one, I think. Oh man. Okay, hold on. Well, we can reforge if we get past the giants. They wouldn't crucify me because they agree. They would crucify for the hypocrisy. You know, and I think that's what really gets people is the hypocrisy, right? All right. Yeah, because this build just doesn't work on giant. No stuns. I don't think they root. I don't think they freeze. We're just toast. Ow, I hit the parry. I actually did. You may not believe me. But that damage also is like... Oh, hang on. Okay, so the root just doesn't work. I was out of spot, like, by a half a pixel. Okay. I'm gonna have to get through this one. Oh, shit. You're gonna do the same... Yeah, the eyes didn't root, unfortunately. Been labbing the lighthouse a lot lately for the fresh file runs. Dude. I hate the lighthouse so much. Oh, it's awful. It's not awful. I'm just so bad at it.